Hello everyone, my name is Lara for PokerNews.com and I'm joined by Felipe Ramos, a player with many strings to his bow. Not only has he won over $2.6 million in career earnings, he is also a GG Poker Ambassador and he's a Twitch streamer on his channel Felipe Mojave. Felipe, you've done absolutely everything, but the one thing that you have not yet to do is win a World Series of Poker bracelet. What would winning a bracelet mean to you?
Yeah, that's a big of accomplishment, I mean, for a career. So, of course, we're trying to get there, doing all we can. But mostly, you need to play well. You need to, like, try to focus a lot whenever there's a series like this. And good results will come. So, good result can come with a bracelet or not. You know, sometimes you don't get a bracelet, but you do financially well, or maybe better than winning a bracelet. But at the point I am right now, financially, I don't really care too much. I'd rather win a tournament than win a lot of money.
On that note, I have to bring it up. Last month, you came painfully close to winning a bracelet in the GG Poker WSOP Online 1K Double Stack. You came second. It was your biggest tournament cash ever for $476,000. But unfortunately, you didn't get that bracelet. When you have a big disappointment like that, is there a particular process you go through to recover mentally?
Well, you remember exactly the amount. Very nice job. I don't even remember because, like, I also I was focusing to win, and I lost. I was a little bit devastated, especially the way I lost the tournament. I was streaming that tournament from the first to the last hand. Completely forgot I was on underwear. Then I lost and went on my couch. Like, it was a mess. And recovering mentally from tournaments, I don't really struggle with this. I just switch in when I start my day, switch off when I finish my day. I like to have my emotions. I think they are part of my myself and part of my game as well. So I don't shut them off while I'm playing. Of course, I try to be reasonable, but like I don't shut them off. So I was very disappointed. And I'm trying to start another day fresh and try it all over again, winning or not, because if I win, that's my life. I'm going to be doing that again and again and again. So trying to reach this accomplishment with winning a bracelet, give to my daughter as a birthday gift, which her birthday is tomorrow. So first time I'm in Vegas, I come here pretty much every year. So now I come here with my family, so I'm very happy.
Amazing. And fortunately, you have plenty more opportunities over the next 2 months to win that bracelet. Are there any particular events you're looking forward to playing?
I pretty much like to play the mixed games over the WSOP because you have the chance to play those tournaments throughout the year. You don't have too much, too many opportunities to play. So I'm looking forward to play most of the mixed events, like the 25K Horse Now, the 50K Players Championship as well. But as you said, lately my results, my best results are on No Limit Holding. So I'm looking forward to those events too.
Amazing. Thank you so much. And I sincerely hope the luck is on your side for the rest of the series.
I mean, I feel blessed. I feel blessed. I have a wonderful family, a wonderful wife, a wonderful daughter. My family is here with me. I feel really good. I think this time it's happening.
Perfect. And you're playing the 25K horse today?
Yes, I mean, we're going half of the day already. Not doing really great, but all that matters that I have chips.
Thank you so much. I'm Lara for PokerNews.com and stay tuned for more exclusive interviews.